New Jersey 101.5. New Jersey Chime Time is 9:09.
From the man who brought you the viral video Bread and Milk, Vic DiBitetto, and from the man who brought you a virus last week, Steve Trevelise.
Ladies and gentlemen, you saw him on Dr. Oz last week, and you're going to see him Friday all over the country in Paul Blart Mall Cop 2, the one, the only, Vic DiBitetto. How are you, my friend?
Hey, Steve, never better, never better.
Dude, you got to be so psyched. Are you counting the days?
I don't sleep anymore. I just walk around and I tell my wife, you just pinch me every 5 minutes. We went to the premiere in New York City. I'm walking a red carpet with my wife. I mean, 33 years ago, we're walking away from the altar. Now we're walking up a red carpet, stopping, taking pictures, press. Phenomenal. Not bad for a garbage man from Brooklyn, huh?
How about that? Garbage man from Brooklyn, right? Did you see all the stuff they're finding on the Jersey Beach?
What's going on? Then again, if I was walking those beaches, it'd be nothing to me. Because when I was a kid, we drove by the garbage dump in Staten Island. My father was driving. He looked at me as the sun was setting on the garbage dump. And he says, see that sun? Long as there's garbage, you're going to eat. Like, thanks, Dad. You got a lifesaver.
They found whoopee cushions, bras, parking meters, all kinds of stuff.
Only in Jersey, man. Whoopee cushions and parking meters.
But Vic,
what are you going to do?
I saw you on Dr. Oz last week, and I got to tell you, I mean, if you get a chance, go to the YouTube page, look at the Dr. Oz appearance. You brought life to that show. I mean, he's good, but you brought life to that show. Every move you made was an attraction, what they call business, right? Where you got to look at Vic. You got to see what he's doing.
Yes. I mean, imagine if you let me loose, give me my own show. You think some TV executive or producer saw that and a light bulb went over their head and said, let me give this guy his own show. I mean, Dr. Oz, don't get me wrong, he's a sweetheart. Matter of fact, after the show, we did a couple of vignettes backstage.
I saw.
He does the look. And he kept going, am I doing the look right? Am I doing the look right? Nice, one of the nicest celebrities I ever met.
Now this Friday is the premiere with Kevin James, Paul Blart, Mall Cop 2.
And not because I'm in it, Steve, but this is going to be better than the first one. It's got laughs. It's funny. It's got a great story. There's action. I'm in a fight scene. I mean, picture the Three Stooges film like The Matrix. It's hilarious. It's hilarious.
Now, how do you do
if you didn't see the first one, you didn't like the first one, you got to see this one. Please, go see it. Because the more of my fans that go, and if the numbers are insane, maybe a light bulb will go off. You know, Kevin James said, wow, let me put this guy in my next movie. You know what I'm saying?
I see spinoff. Gino Toretta. Mark of Torelli. Was it Gino Toretti? Torella? What is
Cizzetti,
it?
Cizzetti.
Gino Cizzetti. Mall Cop Dip.
Please. From your mouth to God's ears. My God, that would be great.
You take over every scene that you're in. I mean, you know, they used you in the preview, but I got to tell you, man, I'm watching that Dr. Oz, and I'm like, look at him. Every movie, like anyone else would just stand there. You're making jokes, you're throwing stuff, and you took over the whole show.
I know, and there was one line they left out, which I don't know why. Remember when they got to the whole milk? They said, what do you like about whole milk? I like whole milk because I drink the whole milk. Nothing. Cut it out. But whatever. Hey, I'm happy. It was a 5-minute segment. A lot of people saw it. And I don't know for what it's worth. When I said goodbye to him, he says, we'll have you back. So we'll see what happens.
Oh, of course he's going to have you back. After next week, everybody's going to want you. When this movie hits, everybody, if it's anything like what you see in the preview, and you're telling me the scenes that are in it, everybody's going to want you. I mean, this is like only the beginning. This is like your Hard Day's Night.
Right. I have a few lines, you know, two or three lines, but if you look behind Paul Blart, I'm always over his shoulder. I'm always with him. Just when you forget about me, I pop up again. It's one of those, like the butler from Mr. Deeds. I pop up and it's a great, it's just, I have a fight scene. I beat Boss Rutan with a lamp. Hilarious. And it felt like 20 minutes. And I tell you, the ending, the way they left the ending, I don't know, man.
You know what? You don't die in this, right? You don't die in this.
No, I don't die.
Good. This is good. My kids love the first
Kevin
one.
James is a sweetheart. He's a regular guy.
Now, he's been promoting it. He's been promoting it all over TV. You see him everywhere now.
It's going to be on Letterman next. It was on GMA. It was on Kelly and Michael. It's going to be on Letterman, I think, one night this week.
All right. And next Friday night, we got the big show over at iPlay.
Yes. Steve, I heard it's almost sold out.
You believe that? And a great
people. If you didn't get your tickets out there, Central Jersey, it's in Freehold, New Jersey, folks.
CatchAndRisingStar.com.
I'm telling you, man, it's going to be a great show. There's going to be a red carpet. We're going to have a good time.
And you're going
to get a babysitter, for God's sake. Come on, get out and laugh. Life is too short.
If you ain't got a babysitter, Vic's got a guy. Don't worry about it. Take care of everything.
Hey, I'll get you a babysitter for $2. Other than that, Steve, I can't complain.
Hey, buddy, we'll talk next week.
You got it. Have a great night.
You got it, my friend. Vic DiBitetto. Can you believe it?